sick puppies. We have Shem, Emma, and Mark. How are you guys doing?
Very well. How are you doing? Thank you.
I'm doing awesome. I'm honored to be standing here with you guys. You guys have blown my mind with the success over the last few years, and many people probably don't know that you guys had a few records before you guys started getting the real recognition that you deserve.
Yeah, we had a record in Australia in 2000, which was on an independent label. But when we tried to work as hard as we could and there wasn't many work left to do in the country, we moved over to the States and made, we're on our third record over here now.
Love it. Like I said, the record, Tripolar, is probably my favorite album of all time, honestly.
Oh, thanks.
And honestly, your voice on White Balloons, woman. Whew. Not to mention your hot.
Have you heard the new album? She sings a lot on the new album.
Yes, I have heard a couple of songs.
But she's like, I don't like
heard all of it. No, I'm so stuck on that album because music is great medicine. And to find people who can channel it into such a powerful way, like songs like You're Going Down, it gets you through the rough times, and the happier ones get you through the good times. And ironically, your song, Odd One, describes my mother perfectly. And you came out with that right after she passed away. So for me, it was a very emotional and helpful tool to get me past the grief. So, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for your presence.
Yeah, thank you.
What is your favorite thing about doing this, getting to be rock stars?
Probably moments
today,
that what you just said.
Oh,
yeah, but...
What are you saying?
No, he was talking about
the
gig.
No, I said, like, today, like, playing festivals.
Today is the gigs, and it really is everything. It's being able to make music full-time and have it connect with people and affect people in a positive way. And you know, that's what just happened now is one of my favorite things, yeah.
Well, I know you don't really remember it, but you guys played at Freebirds several years ago in Jacksonville. And I'll never forget it because you walked by me and you were like, I like your, everything, meaning my style.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was just like blown away. So I was like, whoa, that's a really cool compliment. I don't think anybody's ever said it to me that way before. So that was very cool. Emma, you seem so quiet. Are you shy, sweetheart?
Oh, yeah. I've always been a bit shy, yeah.
Yeah? Why is that?
I don't know. I guess it's, I think it's in the genes, the shyness gene, but,
Not on stage, though.
No, she lets the monster out of there.
Yes, it all comes out.
Do you have an alter ego?
That's why she
name?
Can cage it so well, because it just it gets left on the stage.
Well, that's the thing, like, if you release it, then you just calm again.
Yeah. What about for you? Any favorite thing about all this other than that, or?
Just beating the shit out of stuff. I love it. Drums especially.
Spoken like a true drummer. So how did you guys come together as a group? I know you're all from Australia, but...
No, Mark's from L.A.
You're from L.A. Wow.
Yeah.
How did you guys meet then?
Emma and I met in the music room in high school.
Cool.
And we both love Silverchair, so we started jamming Silverchair, and then we started our band at the end of the week.
Wow.
After we knew all the same songs by the same bands.
Okay.
And then,
you guys
like,
are musical soulmates from the
Yeah. So then we had our first album, like I said before, and we moved over here without our drummer, and we met Mark on Craigslist. For real,
Craigslist.
Yeah.
Wow, that's awesome. The power of social media and internet, huh?
Yeah. Totally.
It's drastically changed this industry. Do you think that's positive, negative, indifferent?
It's positive for bands in our generation, I think, or any.
I mean, I know it makes it harder to sell, especially hard copies of things, but you can also buy a song. The old cassette singles where you don't have to rewind them though. So
yeah.
I don't know. To me, that it seems like it would be a little harder to sell physical stuff, but at the same time, does the actual digital sales make up?
No,
not really.
No.
Sales wise, it's a slippery slope.
Yeah, you don't. Music doesn't sell anymore.
Right.
But
what does? Because I buy it.
Oh well,
I don't
in
pirate
it.
Just so you guys know, I buy all my music.
Oh, good.
I think for us now, or
yeah, that's
I think for any musician or any band or musical act, I think now is just like the live experience. I think is kind of the last kind of sacred thing there is in music. I think that, you know, with social media, everything's you're so out there and you're so kind of exploited.
Documented.
Yeah, which is it's good and. And bad in some ways, maybe, but it's mostly good. But
especially
yeah.
if you like tend to rant up like
yeah.
that.
But people can still go to a rock show and see it live, so that's always going to be around. So that's good.
Do you guys prefer the? I mean, I know obviously any show you play is going to be special to you, but do you guys prefer big shows like this, or do you prefer intimate audiences?
Everyone's got a different opinion on that.
Emma? You know, after playing these two festivals, I realized like how much we miss it. We used to play them a lot, and we've just been to Europe and play some small shows, and there's good and bad about both, but there is something about playing a festival that is just, you just can't get it anywhere else.
You are one of our, I come here every year for this, because of this, and you're right, there is nothing like it. I only ask because where I live, there is a venue that tends to play very intimate shows for very big artists, and it's a totally different vibe, but at the same time, it's really cool to see people in that environment too. It lets you feel like you can actually get closer and watch them, and, you know, as opposed to, I love your glasses.
Oh,
you have like the cat eyes. Are you a cat lover or a dog lover?
Both. I really do love dogs though. I've kind of changed like from cats to loving dogs, but yeah.
Cool. Well guys, your new album is out. How did you come up with the song Gunfight?
That was born off conversations during lunch. Because we would talk about what we saw in the news and what was going on politically and stuff, and then we would get back to work and nothing would change and nothing would happen. And so the concept was, you know, every conversation that doesn't have any specific action is really like bringing a knife to a gunfight. Like, it's not the amount of energy it takes to change a situation like that. You really need to give it your all. And most people talk about it at dinner and then they get on with their lives.
I think you guys started a trend with it too, because Eve to Adam's new album, they don't say it the same way, of course, but he says something similar, the same lines, like, you should know not to bring a knife to a gunfight.
Oh, really?
I think it's Locked and Loaded, the song Locked and Loaded.
Oh, okay, cool. I'll check that out.
Yeah, check it out, because after I heard Gunfight, I heard that and I was like,
That's interesting.
Similar lyric, very cool.
Yeah.
We were first.
You guys, you were the inventors of it. That's why I said they came out to you, and I noticed
it's
that.
It's a very common phrase, though, but it hasn't really been used in a song. Or
it really hasn't been used much in the last decade, you know? True. But now it's like, it's
come back.
Maybe because of the way things have changed and the way people are now, it is coming back around as one of those things because it's more important than me. No, but to me, very powerful. So, you guys, I just can't say thank you enough for your time, and I want to.
So what do I just...
There's all
kinds of cards in there, so just pick whichever one you want.
What's up?
Mermaids. I got mermaids. Okay, so what do I do now?
Anything you want to talk about mermaids for about 30 seconds.
What?
30
just
seconds? That's
me.
A long time.
It doesn't even have to be that long. What's your thoughts about mermaids? Are they real?
Oh, they're fake, and I think they're kind of superfluous. I mean, what's the point of having a mermaid in the first place? Because if all of this just isn't there...
Yes, but you haven't seen the documentary,
He's obsessed with Ariel.
I am too. She's hot.
Under the sea. Yeah. I really was when I was a kid. Yeah, actually, that's going to be my footnote. Ariel is the quintessential mermaid. Shim out.
And just guess if magic happens and she got her mermaids.
Yeah.
You're going to keep that autographed after that.
Okay, cool. No problem.
Miss Emma? Yes, ma'am.
All right.
You should have picked the one in. You would have gotten Harry Potter.
Oh, true.
Pandora box.
Pandora's box.
Pandora's box.
Like the box that if it's open, all that's left at the bottom is hope, and it releases all the world's sorrows to the world.
Oh, really? Is that what
it said? Greek mythology.
Oh.
Wait, there's nothing left but
sadness. Nothing left but hope at the bottom of the box.
There is hope.
Yes, when the box is open, all the grief and all the pain comes out, and all that's left in the box is open.
Well, actually, that's, I wasn't quite sure. I thought Pandora's box was just like a phrase about, you know, letting the floodgates open, and once you do, it all comes out. But thank you for that, because I didn't know that.
It is very similar. It's the same concept, like the floodgates come out of everything.
Right.
But in Greek mythology, yes, Pandora's box is very real, and supposedly once the god of the Athena or whoever opened it, all the despair and plagues went onto the world and all that was over. So that's how they restored themselves. So
I like that.
Thanks for the hope in your music, and that's very cool. I like your twist on that one.
All right, cool.
Marcus. Clouds. Funny you should say that, because I actually love the clouds structure today. There's a cumulus nimbus over here that I really love.
And
that's
cumulus is
forming.
Right here.
And
cirrus clouds up there.
Yes, that's it. And I saw a supercell actually.
Really?
Yeah, with the water spout about to go down.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I was a bit of an amateur
Did
meteorologist.
I have those, and so, I'll show you. Do you guys have water spouts too?
No, I haven't seen
We actually saw one. This is where we saw that water spout.
Yeah, we It's all in Florida.
I have zero idea what you're talking about.
It's a spout of water that looks like a tornado on the beach.
Yeah, like a tornado.
Yeah, we were quite worried, actually, because we were like, oh my god, is that?
They don't go anywhere. They stay right there.
Yeah. Is that real?
That's a real thing,
yeah.
I swear. I remember it from third grade. Really good.
Cool. Well, guys, thank you so much for all your time.
Thank you.
All I want is you're welcome. And guys, thank you for just being you and rocking out. No, I want you. I'm gonna give you a little Sharpie to autograph those, and then we'll be done. Guys, Sick Puppies, Rockville 2014, Evie Star, EvieStarMusic.com, Z13Radio.com, and UProductionsLLC.com.